trouble continued to brew. It was a time for action and a time for words. On a hot July night in 1776, Benjamin Franklin was aroused from his work by the call of destiny.
Hey, you in there, Ben?
Who's that, Sylvia?
It's the call of destiny.
Come on, take a look through the curtains there.
It's Tom Jefferson.
What, again? Well, it's no good. I'll have to let him in. I'm coming.
Hi, Ben.
Tom?
You got a minute?
Well, I tell you the truth, we were just going out of town for the weekend.
But it's only Wednesday.
Yeah. Well, you know, a penny saved is a penny earned.
What does that got to do with anything, Franklin?
I don't know. It's the first thing that came into my head. I was just making conversation. An idle brain is the devil's playground, you know.
So you're pretty good at that, aren't
you? Yeah, there's some new wise sayings I just made up.
Wise sayings?
Yeah, I call them wise sayings.
Mm-hmm.
What can I do for you?
Well, I got this petition here I've been circulating around the neighborhood. Mm-hmm. Kind of thought you'd like to sign it. It's called the Declaration of Independence.
Yeah, I heard about that. Sounds a little suspect, if you ask me.
What do you mean, suspect?
Well, you're advocating the overthrow of the British government by force and violence, aren't you?
Well, yeah, but we've had it with that royal jazz.
Who's we?
Well, all the guys.
Who's all the guys?
Oh, George, Jim Madison, Alex Hamilton, Johnny Adams, you know, all the guys.
The lunatic fringe.
Oh, they are not.
Bunch of wild-eyed radicals. Professional liberals, don't kid me.
Oh, you call George Washington a wild-eyed radical?
Washington? I don't see his name on there.
No, but he promised to sign it.
Oh, yeah, that's George for you. Talks up a storm with them wooden teeth. Can't shut him off. When it comes time to put the name on the old parchment of Rooney, try and find him.
Hey, what are you so surly about today?
Surly to bed and surly to rise.
Oh, all right, let's knock off the one-line jokes and sign the petition. What do you say, huh, fella?
Well, let me skim down it here. When in the course of human events, so-and-so, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
That's pursuit of happiness.
Well, all your S's look like F's here.
No, it's stylish.
Oh, I see.
It's in. It's very in.
Oh, well, if it's in. We therefore, the representatives of the United States of America, so-and-so, solemnly publish and declare that they are absolved from all allegiance to the British crown, and so on. A little overboard, isn't it?
Oh, well,
you write this?
Yeah, I knocked it out. It's just a first draft, you know.
Well, I tell you, why don't you leave it with me and I'll mail it in, huh?
Oh, come on.
No, I tell you, Tom, let me say this. I'm with you in spirit. I'm sure you understand that, but, you know, I got to play it conservative. I'm a businessman.
Yeah.
I got the printing business going pretty good. Almanac made Book of the Month. And then I got the inventions, you know. Got pretty good distribution on the stoves now. And, of course, every Saturday evening, I bring out the mag.
The what?
Magazine.
Oh. Oh, that reminds me, that artist I sent by, did you look at his stuff?
You mean the Rockwell boy? Skinny kid with the pipe?
Yeah, that's a kid.
Yeah, I glanced at it, and he's too far out for me.
Oh, yeah. Well, I know you got to play it safe.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
But getting back to the signing of the petition, how about it, huh?
Well,
it's a harmless paper.
Oh, sure, harmless. I know how these things happen. You go to a couple of harmless parties, sign a harmless petition, and forget all about it. 10 years later, you get hauled up before a committee. No, thank you. I'm not going to spend the rest of my life writing in Europe.
Oh, come on.
Come on what?
Come on and put your name on the dotted line.
I got to be particular what I sign.
It's just a piece of paper.
Just a piece of paper, that's what you say.
Come on and put your signature on the list.
It looks to have a very subversive twist.
How silly to assume it. Won't you nom de plume it today? You're so skittish. Who possibly could care if you do?
The Un-British Activities Committee. That's who.
Let's have a little drinko and fill the quill.
It sounds a little pinko to me, but still.
Knock off the timid manner if you want a banner to raise.
Banner to raise.
you must take,
I must take
a stand,
a stand
for this brave,
for this brave
new land,
new land,
for who wants,
who wants
to live,
to live,
so concerned,
so concerned,
but
if I don't dis,
he don't
disagree,
agree,
but a man can't be too careful what he signs these days.
Well, if I sign it, will you renew your subscription?
Yeah, if you promise not to keep throwing it on the roof.
Well,
if it isn't on the roof, it's in the rose bushes or in the mud.
My eyesight isn't what it used to be, you know. Besides, it's hard to hit the porch from a horse.
Now, come on. All we want to do is hold a few truths to be self-evident.
You sure it's not going to start a revolution or anything?
Trust me.
Okay, give it to me. You got a quill on you?
Yeah, here you are.
Look at this show-off Hancock, will you? Pretty flamboyant signature for an insurance man.
Ah, you did a good thing, Ben. You won't be sorry. Now, if I can just get another 3 or 4 guys, we'll be all set.
Well, I tell you one thing.
What's that?
You better get them to sign it in the next couple of days before they all take off for the 4th of July weekend.